You guys do not understand how much fiddling it took to get this set up to look somewhat decent. Hi guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Lauren. If this is your first time here, and in today's video, I'm just playing with makeup. You know, fall's around the corner and I'm really excited about that, but I don't really wear as much makeup anymore because, you know, when I'm working, I wear masks the majority of the day. So, and then like, I don't like get messing up my mask as much and getting like having that rubbing against my skin. So I just opt not to wear it. So this is the one day I get to just wear makeup and play in it and just have fun with it. So I figured I'd ventured into trying some fall looks and everything. Of course, using products that I already have. I've been trying to do, I've been sticking to my no buy. I've only been buying things that I actually need. So I do have lashes because the ones that I have been wearing have been wearing out, and I ran out of brow pencil, mascara. So those are the little things that I've been buying. So okay, so for primer, I'm going in with my Milk Hydro Grip. This trial size has lasted me a very long time, so I don't think even when I run out of this I'll buy the full version. I think I'll just buy the trial size since it's lasted me so long. I have that in the trial size, and also the Farsali Skin Tint Blur, which is also really good. But both of them got to the trial size and they lasted me a long time. So I'm really just going through the motions just to do it because I don't really need it to last very long. Has anybody else like, I think I'm getting like allergic or, you know, cause I wash my mask very frequently and everything, but I think having fabric rub up against my skin for extended periods of time, for like hours at a time, like I don't think my skin likes it. So I've been breaking out on my chin area and it gets really itchy, and then sometimes like areas around my eyes will get itchy, and yeah, it's very annoying. Since I'm gonna be doing a smoky eyeshadow, I think I want to do like brown smoky eye. I'm gonna do my base last, so I'm just gonna take a little bit of my e.l.f. concealer and use that as a eyeshadow base. It's a week from Monday is when I officially start grad school. I already have homework and stuff for my classes, but I've been working on that, which is exciting. Hopefully we'll have more information in regards to COVID by then, so we'll know if we'll have more classes on the ground or not. Yeah, I'm just gonna take bronzer as a transition shade first before I start going in with the darker shadows. So I'm still getting used out of my Jackie Aina palette. I'm taking Ginger and putting that in my crease as well, just to warm it up just a little bit. And then I'm gonna finally start to go in with the browns. I want this to be like a deep, you know, a deep brown. All right, so I'm liking the point at which it's at now. So I think I'm gonna break here. I'm just making sure everything is blended nicely. I've been going in between my Jackie palette and then my Jaclyn Hill palette because I like the browns in there too. So I could be doing this for hours. So I'm gonna pop off screen and pop off camera and do my eyebrows. And then I think I'll finish up the eyes and then do my face. Yeah, I think I wanna finish up my eyes and then, you know, not have to come back. So that's what I'm gonna do. Okay, so this is as done up as they're getting because they're already thick to begin with. I think this year really makes 2 years since I've gone and gotten them professionally done. So I just trim them as I see fit, but I just use the Maybelline Brow Ultra Slim. I think I have it in the shade. Where's the shade on it? I think it's in black brown. Yep, 262 black brown. Done there. I'm gonna do eyeliner because I find that today, like if I was gonna wear this makeup with a mask, like all my face would be covered up, but it would just be my eyes doing the talking. So I would wanna do as much as I can to, of course, draw attention to the eyes. So I'm getting back into liner, which is fun. This eyeliner I'm using is from Wet n Wild, and it's their waterproof one. Yo, it really doesn't move. You have to work at it to get it to come off. So if you have watery eyelids, this I think will work really well. And this applicator makes it really easy to get in my tear duct and do it, so. I'm sure I'm gonna have to fix it once I put my concealer and everything on, but yeah, I won't make y'all sit through the other one. Now I can finally work on my skin. I think I'm in the mood to mix foundation, so I'm gonna take my Cover FX Power Play. This is matte, and my Fenty Hydrating, and mix the two. Of course, focusing the Power Play on my T-zone. And the hydrating everywhere else. I haven't worn a Power Play in a long time. Going for my Fenty than my Pat more lately. Well, it's still lovely. Every time I watch Alyssa or Arnell, they're always wearing the Power Play, and I'm like, oh my gosh, I have this. Let me wear it. Yeah, nowadays there's really no point to wear foundation or anything because this whole bottom half of my face, this whole part of my face covered up. Y'all remind me to blow out that candle so I won't have a house fire. That would totally suck. For concealer, I'm going back in with the e.l.f. Hydrating to really like conceal everything. And then I'll go in with the NYX Born to Glow to really brighten. Starting with this one, and then I'll put the NYX everywhere else. I can really do my base really quickly. It's just when I'm real persnickety about how my eyes look, that's when everything starts adding up time-wise. To set all the concealed areas, I'm going to take my Huda baking powder. I use the shade Blondie. And I'm not going to bake, I'm just going to set everything. That's not that serious. There are some powders that if I don't be careful with how I distribute it on the brush or the sponge, like it'll look crazy. crazy. So this powder doesn't really do that. I'm gonna leave some extra powder on my nose to set some more, but while that's waiting, I'm going to bronze using my Fenty bronzer. For blush, I'm taking my blush from Minted. It's in the shade Peach for the Stars. And it has like a sheen in it already, so I don't have to wear a highlight. Why not use this? I really like that. So since it has glow in it already, I can really try to focus it on my cheekbones. All right, so I'm finally almost finished. Just have my lip to do. So I'm gonna take my Stunna lip paint and unveil, and that'll be a wrap. Is actually a dress from, it's called H&M, and I saw this trick from Miriam. She turned a lot of her dresses into shirts, so I thought that would be fun. I have to take some back to the mall real quick, so do that. So this is from H&M. These are from American Eagle. Okay, so this is the final look, guys. I hope y'all enjoyed it. I had a lot of fun doing it. Renee's rushing me, so I gotta go. I'll have all of the products listed down in the description box below, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.